Tales of Did you slay this eater? Your orders were to await the main force before engaging.
No, Captain. It wasn't us, I swear it. A man came out of nowhere and cut it down before we knew what was happening.
By himself? Certainly it is no light warden, but nevertheless.
It's true. Felled it with a single swing of his axe, he did. Never seen anything like it. So I says to him, who are you, the warrior of bleeding darkness? And he says no. I'm a warrior of light. And that was it. Buggered off as quick as he came.
A warrior of light?
Why would someone go around calling himself that, though? It was those bastards who caused the flood. I mean, if you were going to pretend to be anyone, it'd be her. The warrior of darkness.
Hey? Oh, I didn't know. It's an honor.
Since the Eater is no longer a threat, our work here is done. Return to your posts.
I had hoped to fight at your side today. But I'll continue to follow your example, and may we meet again.
I apologize for the waste of journey. It seems I overestimated the threat. As for this warrior of light, I do not know who would be brazen enough to take that mantle for his own. Whatever it may once have meant, it is forever tainted by the association with the Flood. The Exarch told me the truth of Ardbert and his comrades' deeds, and I am aware they played some part in your own triumph. But to most, they are synonymous with the calamity that befell this world. Still, if this man is minded to destroy Sin Eaters, I may forgive him his unfortunate choice of alias. But that is neither here nor there. I thank you for accompanying me.
With that concluded, shall we return to the Crystarium? There is a proposal I should like to make.
Forgive me. There is one more thing. A personal concern of mine. I had hoped you might have a moment to speak privately.
Take your time. I shall go on ahead.
I will not mince words. This matter concerns the Exarch. Though his countenance belies his age, his demeanor never has. He has seen more than any man should and grown ever more weary with time. But I see I give the wrong impression. While it is true he attempted to open a letter with a salmon fillet the other evening, we are not here because I suspect his mind is deteriorating. Nor do I believe him to be so maddeningly unconcerned by the prospect of his own death as he once was. Indeed, the opposite is true. It is for this reason that I seek your advice. Since he returned from the Tempest, the Exarch is not as he was. He seems a different man. A younger man. I know not the details of his research, but when I saw him at work recently, there was a glint in his eye that I had never seen before. He looked happy. It was as if he had peered into the future and for the first time found joy there. Though it gladdens me to see him thus, I wonder if I should not keep my distance. I fear that my presence will only anchor him to the past, remind him of all the pain that came before. Is that so? Then perhaps we might remain as we were. As we have always been. What a relief. In that case, I will have to speak with him about the amount of time he is spending at work. This research is important, I know, but if he refuses to consider his own health, I will have to consider it for him.
Thank you.
Yes, this looks to be nearly everyone. Let us begin, shall we? Though I am usually the first to hold forth at such events, I think on this occasion that honour should fall to you.
They would be more inclined to take the word of the Warrior of Darkness.
Indeed. In light of the subject matter, who better than thee to speak these truths?
Thank you. Oh, yes.